Okay, let's try to answer some more email here. Dear Kurt, I just saw your video, Broken Japanese Dream, on YouTube. You mentioned that you have difficulties living in Japan because your wife has to blend in with the society and being Japanese, and therefore she has the expectation of a husband that can be the leader of the family and the breadwinner. Would you please elaborate more purely from the Japanese point of view of the expectations of family leader and breadwinner? I'm interested to understand about this matter because seriously, I had a Japanese girlfriend back then for 4 years and spent 2 years living under the same roof. She started to behave differently around 6 months before we suddenly broke up out of the blue, and she said the reason why we were not compatible to each other was because I was not Japanese, and therefore she could not expect Japanese husbandness from me. I completely have no idea what she meant by that, so I really hope that I hope that you can help me out in understanding the Japanese society's point of view of a husband. Thank you very much, Kurt. I will highly appreciate your explanation of this. Yeah, this is a real challenging one, because the relationships like this, especially if you meet young. In my case, I met my wife when we were both in our early 20s, and she was I don't think it's incorrect to say she was fleeing Japan. She told me so. She was trying to escape Japan, and therefore what she found in the West was very interesting and exciting for her, including me. We met almost immediately after she arrived, and I was nothing like anybody in Japan, and that worked as long as we were in the States. And in fact, we did come back for Japan for 2 years, and it even worked then. I think she was still under the spell of not being in Japan by being, you know, with me and around me. But that all changed after we had a child. It's been really changed after we came back to Japan, where she basically... Oh, man, I just deleted that email. See? Oh, no, deleted the email by accident. Sorry. So I'll have to get back to it. She... fumble fingers here. So she... we got back to the States, and... I'll go back to Japan, and she reverted into her role of a Japanese mother and housewife. And what that meant was that she, and that's a hard, hard job. And being such a difficult job, she has had a reasonable expectation that I would rise to the challenge of the Japanese husband, which is a different role from an American husband. A Japanese husband is less an equal with his wife, in terms of, you know, in the American household, we see, okay, we've got the mortgage, we've got the kids, we've got the utilities, we've got the save for retirement. We're going to do this as a team, kind of together, and we're going to come up with solutions on how to do this. And it may be unconventional. It may be that we'll do the traditional model, and the husband goes off and works, or the wife stays behind and takes care of the kids, or we may both have jobs and do that, or the wife may take the lead role as the breadwinner and the husband stay home. And in any case, they're always on par in terms of being equals in either situation. In Japan, that's not the way it works. In Japan, the vast majority of the time, it's the traditional model. The husband basically leaves the house in the morning, typically before the family, especially the kids, are even up, and he's gone before the kids even get back. The old adage in Japan, which you may have heard, is that a good husband, Japanese housewives say, a good husband is healthy and absent. In that capacity, your job as a husband is to be a reliable breadwinner, to be a bit of an aloof authoritarian around the household, not a tyrant by any means, but your job is to be the figurehead. Japanese husbands are typically rather quiet, especially after marriage. They can be very, very, as boyfriends, they can be very, very loving and caring, but as soon as they get married, they become kind of aloof, and they kind of take their wife as their, you know, it's kind of just almost taking their wives for granted in a way. And in a way that kind of works for the wives, because their attention is on the kids. They can focus on that, and they don't have to focus a lot of attention on the husband. Well, they do have to take care of him, because he's kind of like a big baby in some ways. So they do have to take care of him. So your wife will take care of you, great take care of you, but she will also expect you to stay out of her way. And she will also expect you to provide well for the family, and to not make a lot of noise, not make a lot of fuss for her or the family. Do your Sunday service to take them to the park or to Marine, you know, Disneyland or whatever the case may be. And for the most part, your job is to make the money, to be the leader and the authoritarian and the disciplined guy, and to make sure that everything runs smoothly in that capacity. That's what most Japanese wives are after. But what they get with us American men, in particular North American men, is they get us, we want this kind of, we want the dating to continue. The, you know, the long chats, the let's take a walk together, let's go out and have dinner together, leave the kids with the sitter and go out to dinner together. And this kind of this neediness that we don't perceive it as neediness. In the West, with our Western women, it's kind of a partnership type of thing. But here in Japan, it doesn't quite work that way. And they want that. And I think, and what happened for me coming to Japan is that I can't do any of that, and I certainly cannot be the lion, so to speak, you know, the leader of the pride taking care of things, because I'm basically another kid. I'm embarrassed to say this, but my wife has to take care of me. She has to read the documents that they send home from work, the official documents, and sign. Help me sign things and take me down to the city hall when I need to get things done. I can do some of these things for myself, but a lot of them I can't. And it's, you know, I'm getting nervous. I'm anxious right now. I'm actually, you know, piling up little rocks here because this whole thing pisses me off. I'm pissed at myself that I can't do those things. So that frustrates her too, because that distracts her from her duty. She has to take care of me. That's what your girlfriend probably meant. She was realizing that you weren't going to fit that role, just as I can't fit that role. And it can be a real source of strain for couples when that occurs. It's something to watch out for if you get in that situation. I don't know as much about the reverse Japanese men and Western wives. I imagine they have their challenges too, in an inverse kind of a way. That's what it's all about. And that's part of the reason I want to get back to the States, so that I can be the man of the house again. Because that's another thing. My wife is a girly girl. It's a more traditional woman. She wants a man that can, you know, be a man. she doesn't want to be the wife and wear the pants in the house, so to speak. You know, that doesn't mean I'm a bad guy, doesn't mean I'm a tyrant or anything like that, but when push comes to shove, I'm the guy that'll do it, and I can do that better back there than I can here. So that's why, one of the reasons I want to get back. I hope that answers your question, friend. Now I just got to retrieve your email, which I just deleted, and so I don't lose it so I can send you this. Take care, friend. Sorry to be so long getting back to you. Bye-bye.